الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد সম্মানিত মুসল্লিবৃন্দ মহান রব্বুল আলামিনের শুকরিয়া আদায় করছি আল্লাহ রব্বুল আলামিন আমাদেরকে পবিত্র জুমাতে একত্রিত হওয়ার সুযোগ দিয়েছেন এবং তার পবিত্র ঘরে পবিত্র মন পবিত্র আত্মা এবং পবিত্র শরীর নিয়ে আমরা একত্রিত হয়েছি মহামহিম আমাদেরকে এই সুযোগ করে দেওয়ার জন্য তার এই দরবারে আমরা সবাই শুকরিয়া আদায় করে বলি আলহামদুলিল্লাহ We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this opportunity that Allah has given us tawfiq to be in the house of Allah with pure intention and with clean body and with very high spirit. This is indeed favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us. In today's khutbah, we like to focus on some points. First is, during month of December, people around us preparing themselves to celebrate their great festival, which is Christmas. So what is our duty as Muslim in this month? Should we join them in celebration? What is our duty towards our kids who are going to school and whole month, whether it is a state school or Catholic school or any private school, people are busy with the stories of Christmas, stories of Jesus, and many other kind of stories. So, as a Muslim, what kind of belief and creed related with this kind of Christmas stories. How we should protect mind of our children. This is indeed great challenge for Muslims living in the West, living in the Christian society or non-Muslim societies. So, my dear brothers, elders, it is very important that we remember that we have big obligation on us. And I think that one of the most important responsibility is, as a Muslim, we should read verses of Surah Maryam to our children during this time. To give them proper knowledge of Islam regarding Jesus, regarding Christmas, and regarding other matters related with that. আমাদের বড় একটা দায়িত্ব হলো যে আমাদের বাচ্চারা যারা স্কুলে যায় পুরো মাসটি তারা এক ধরনের সেলিব্রেশনের ভিতর দিয়ে যায় এবং তারা বিভিন্ন ধরনের গল্প কাহিনী স্কুল থেকে প্রতিদিন শুনে এবং বিভিন্ন রকম গান সং ক্যারল ইত্যাদি তারা শিখে এর বিপরীতে ইসলামের আকীদা বিশ্বাসের সাথে এই বিশ্বাসগুলোর মৌলিক পার্থক্যগুলোকে আমাদের তাদের কাছে হাইলাইট করা দরকার নতুবা এটাই হয়ে যাবে তাদের মূল স্রোত ধারার সেলিব্রেশন এবং মুসলমান হিসেবে যে স্বাতন্ত্র আমাদের যে পৃথক একটা সত্তা এবং বিশ্বাস আছে সেটা আমরা আমাদের নেক্সট জেনারেশনের কাছে পাস না করার কারণেই আমরা দোষী সাব্যস্ত হয়ে যাব সো দিস ইজ এ চ্যালেঞ্জ উই হ্যাভ টু পাস থ্রু নলেজ ক্রিয়েট আকিদা টু নেক্সট জেনারেশন আদারওয়াইজ দে উইল অ্যাকিউজ আস অন দ্য ডে অফ রিজারেকশন ইফ ইউ আস্ক হু ওয়াজ দ্য হাজব্যান্ড অফ মারিয়াম মেরি টু ইউর kid who is going to nursery or reception or year one? Immediately who will reply? Joseph. Who is Jesus? Maybe some of them will answer, Son of God. Your son will say, Jesus, Son of God. Your son will say, the husband of Maryam, Mary is Joseph. Your son or your child will reply that Christmas is a celebration for birth of Son of God. Yes, they will say. But in contrast, we have to fulfill our duty towards them. That's why I request today those who attended in today's Jummah Khutbah and also all viewers who are watching this program through Iqra TV, I would like to request them, please read Surah Maryam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor them. Muslim honor mother of Jesus. In Quran, there is no name for any female, any woman, directly. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not use any proper noun for any female. Only one mentioned in Quran, which is Maryam, Mary. Not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us one surah, whole chapter, in Juz 16 and chapter number 19. The chapter name is Surah to Maryam. Not only one and two times Allah mentioned, many times Allah mentioned Isa ibn Maryam, Masih ibn Maryam, and directly Maryam. Allah mentioned many other women, their story, but did not mention by name. Allah onek mohilar golpo ghotona Qurane ullekh korechen, tobe nam dhore shudhu Maryam er nam ullekh hoyeche. Yes, Allah mentioned wife of Lut, Allah mentioned wife of Noah, Allah mentioned wife of Firaun, their story. Daraballahu mathalan lil ladhina kafaru imra'ata Nuhin wa imra'ata Lut كانتا تحت عبدين من عبادنا صالحين فخانتاهما فلم يغني عنهما من الله شيئا. Mention two examples of non-believers. Although they were under two prophets, Lut and Nuh, but they were non-Muslim, non-believers. Wife of Lut, wife of Nuh. On other hand, the biggest enemy of Allah in the history, who is Firaun, but his wife, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا امْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ بِنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Example of a believer is wife of Firaun. Although she was under Firaun, who said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمْ وَلَعَلَى, I'm your greatest Rabb. But his wife was believer, true believer. And she said to Allah, supplicated to Allah, she said, oh Allah, build up a special house for me in Jannah. And release me from the torture of Firaun and from his action. Then Allah said, wa Maryam ibnat Imran allati ahsanat farjaha. Maryam, daughter of Imran. So Maryam, Mary, mother of Jesus, and daughter of Imran. Not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the family of Imran with one surah. And the chapter is third chapter of Quran, third surah of Quran, Surah to Ali Imran. Imran is a grandfather of Isa alayhi salam, Jesus. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam nanan nam hulu Imran. Among ei Imran er poribar niye Allah ekti surah nazil korechen. Surati naam hulo Suratu Ali Imran. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala special surah revealed for Isa alayhi salam and his miracle Al-Ma'idah, Surah Al-Ma'idah. One of the longest surah in Quran, Surah Al-Ma'idah. And it is regarding the special miracle Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down a special food and meal from heaven to Isa alayhi salam with request of his followers, which is called Ma'idah. Allah Ta'ala bishesh khabarer intizam korechilen, byabostha korechen, jetake Ma'idah bola hoy. So Maryam, mother of Isa, She was very practicing and pious. Because time is short, I don't want to give all the stories related with Maryam. Just I request all brothers to read Surah Maryam, especially from verse 16. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started Surah Maryam, verse from 16. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمِ إِذِ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. O Messenger, mention the story of Maryam in the book. So Allah ordered his prophet to mention, discuss about the story of Maryam. So noble woman and lady, Allah Ta'ala order korchen, nirdesh diyechen, je apni Maryamer ghotona bolen. So this order is not only to our prophet, it is order to every one of us to mention, to discuss. So especially during December and during Christmas time, we should mention the story of Maryam to our children, which is true revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She was far from her family in East area. Makan and Sharqiyya. Sharq means the in east area, eastern area. And fattakhazat min dunihim hijaba, she was in a hijab. So hijab not only for Muslim, even mother of Jesus, she used to wear hijab. It is a special clothing, also used as a cover, as a curtain. The word hijab used in many meanings. So suddenly, she saw a man is coming to her. It is not normal man, ordinary man. This man was Jibreel in form of human. Bashar and Sawiyya. This man, Bashar, human, came to approaching to Maryam. She was afraid and scared, worried. She said, قالت إني أعوذ بالرحمن منك إن كنت تقيا. Suddenly she said, I fear Allah. I refuse, I seek protection from Allah, from you. Go away. If you fear Allah, go away from me. Allah ke bhoy korle tumi dure jao. Tini mone korechilen sadharon ekjon purush tar kache asche. Qala. This angel replied, Innama ana rasul rabbik. I'm not ordinary man. I'm a special messenger from your Rab to you. Ami bishesh ekta protinidhi tomar Rabber pokkho theke tomar kache perite hoyeche. Ana rasul rabbik. I'm a messenger, a special messenger who came from your Rab. What is the purpose? Why I came? Li ahaba laki ghulaman zakiya. Allah send me to give to you a son. And Zakiya, who is very pure, blessed. Pobitra ekti shantan tomake deyar jonno ami eshechi. Qalat. She was surprised and said, Anna yakunu li ghulamun wa lam yamsasni bashar wa lam akun baghiya. How I will get a son and no man touch me ever. And also I am not a bad woman. Ami to kono kharap potita me na kono purusher sathe amar sporshe ami jaini. কোন পুরুষ আমাকে স্পর্শ করেনি আবার আমার কি করে সন্তান হতে পারে হাউ ইজ ইট পসিবল قال كذلك قال ربك هو علي هين ولنجعله آية للناس ورحمة منا وكان أمرا مقضيا. Your Rob said, it is very easy for your Rob to give you son without any husband, without any father. Allah can do whatever he wants. Allah praman kurte chan, ja Allah sharpo shukti ban, jita Allah chan shita kurte paren. Wa kaina amran maqdiya, this matter already decided by your Rab. Ita na hoar ar kono shujug nahi, ita hobi. This is a sign and this is a mercy. So Jesus, he was rahma. He was mercy. As our last and final messenger, he was rahmatul lil alameen. Mercy to whole universe. Same, Isa alayhi salam, he was also mercy to mankind. And he was sign, ayah, power of Allah. Christian of Najran came to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and they said, if Isa is not son of God, so who is his father? How people will be in this dunya without father? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. It is a power, a special power of Allah. If you can't believe that Isa has no father, so Allah is his father. So who is father of Adam? Inna mathala Isa kamathali Adam. Isa, at least he has mother. But Adam, who is his father and mother? If Allah can create Adam without father and both father and mother, so why Allah would not be able to create Isa and Jesus without father? It is easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do anything. Allah jeta iccha shetai korte paren. So this was the special sign. So then Maryam, she was in pregnancy with Jesus, with Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, Masih ibn Maryam. Then she came, فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَادُ إِلَىٰ جِزَعِ النَّخْلَىٰ. When she felt the pain of pregnancy for delivery, she came far away. And قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا. With the pain, with the worries, with the shame of family and mankind, she was so upset. She said, يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا. Oh, if I died before that shameful incident, and people will forget me. Aha, ami jodi ekhon mara jetam, manush jodi amar kotha ekbare bhulei jeto, Maryam name keo chilo eta jodi bhulei jeto, ami kotoi na beche jetam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him comfort. All the sign, all the miracles, all the power of Allah. Then Allah said, don't worry, I will show you some sign now. وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِزَيْ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطَ عَلَيْكِ رَطَبًا جَنِيًّا. Look, you are under palm, date palm. So it is empty and dry. Now you will find a miracle and power of Allah. Draw it, draw one branch to you. You will find that very fresh dates is coming to you. তুমি দেখো, যে গাছটির নিচে তুমি শুয়ে আছো, খেজুরের গাছ, শুকনো, কোনো খেজুর নেই, এখনই তোমাকে দেখাবো আমার শক্তি এবং পাওয়ার, তুমি টান দাও তোমার দিকে। তিনি খেজুর গাছটিকে টান দিলেন, ঝরঝরে তাজা খেজুর, রতবান, রতব বলা হয় ফ্রেশ তাজা খেজুরকে, তোমার কাছে চলে আসবে। তোমার পানি দরকার, মরুভূমি কোনো পানি নেই, দিস ইজ ডেজার্ট এরিয়া, নো ওয়াটার, বাট নাও ইউল ফাইন্ড ওয়াটার। আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা সেড, فناداها من تحتها ألا تحزني. Don't worry. قد جعل ربك تحتك سريا. You need water? Look at behind you. Underneath of your feet, you will find the water. So she got water. And also fresh date. Allah said, فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي. Now eat and drink. وَقَرِّ عَيْنَا. And be in comfort and peace. তুমি আরাম করো, অস্থির হয়ো না, কোনো ভয়ের কোনো কারণ নেই। সো লং স্টোরি, দেন হোয়েন জিসাস অর ঈসা আলাইহিস সালাম কেম ইন দিস দুনিয়া, আল্লাহ অর্ডার, নাও গো টু ইউর লোকালিটি উইথ দিস বয়, উইথ দিস বেবি, বাচ্চাটিকে নিয়ে যাও। হোয়েন পিপল সো দিস বেবি, দে সেড, ইয়া উখতা হারুন, ما كان أبوك امرأة سوء وما كان أمك بغية. You are from noble family, from the family of very special noble person whose name was Harun, and your father was also very prominent scholar of Jewish, and also your mother was very pious and practicing. How you commit this kind of sin? কিভাবে তুমি বিবাহ ছাড়া বাচ্চা প্রসব করতে পারলে? So those people who follow the true Christianity, they should know that outside marriage, if somebody give birth of any son or daughter, according to Christianity, it is also haram and it is also very sin, they are committing sin. But nowadays, those who claim themselves also Christian, they are doing live together, all kind of relation without marriage. So they are not true followers of Isa or Maryam or Christianity even. فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ سَبِيَّ. People asked, who is this boy? She said, I am fasting, I can't talk. In that time, when people fast, they can't speak. So if you have any question, ask the baby. So people was become more angry, they got angry. You are joking with us? How will you speak to boy, baby, who is very newborn baby? But immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave power to Isa alayhi salam. He sat down and said, Qala inni Abdullah, atani al-kitab. Your question regarding me? Answer is, I am not bastard or not haram. I am servant of Allah. So true identity of Isa alayhi salam is Abdullah, son of Allah. They said son of God, we said servant of Allah. So both S, but differently they are calling him son of God. As a Muslim and believers, we said servant. So son and servant. This is the very highlighted difference between two groups. And he said, Allah ordered me to establish the prayer and zakah. He will give me book. And Allah sent me to be kind to my mother. This was the brief teaching of Isa alayhi salam, he said when he was very newborn baby. So now, question was, that during Christmas, what is our duty? First duty, all children, all kids are going to nursery, reception, schools. We should discuss with them the story of Maryam. And we should all together, family members should recite Surah Maryam, especially start verse number 16. And one or two ruku and brief story we should pass and transfer to our children. They should not tell that Maryam has husband who is Joseph. Maryam gave birth of son of God. So this two highlighted mistake and wrong we should clear to our next generation. Second frequently asked question, should we decorate our house? Not from creed or from belief, but as a celebration. According to a scholar, it is not allowed. Because Christmas related with the belief, the Son of God, which is biggest shirk and major sin in Islam, Muslims should avoid any kind of imitating or copying of this culture. Onekei bolen je amra ghor ki sajate pari, decorate korte pari baire bhitore. এটা বিশ্বাস থেকে না, জাস্ট একটু আনন্দের জন্য, বাচ্চাদের আনন্দের জন্য। No. Instead, it is our duty to decorate our masjid, decorate our houses during Ramadan and Eid. And we should give them focus that our main and major festival is Eid, Eid al-Fitr, Eid al-Adha. Prophet ﷺ denied those people who used to celebrate in Medina before Islam with some kind of festival. He said, no. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed with two great festivals, which is Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. You can't celebrate any other celebration, festival. Allah Nabi Madina deshe dekhchen, Madinar manushra nairoz palam kore, unno utshob kore. Allah Nabi bolechen, na, Allah amaderke duta utshob diyechen, Eid al-Fitr, Eid al-Adha. Sheguloke celebration kora dorkar. But unfortunately, many Muslims, they don't decorate their houses or they do any celebration during this time, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. It is wrong. Amader kora dorkar. Amader Eidir anondoke boro kore prokash kora dorkar. Jate kore bachchara bujhe Muslimander pithok ekta celebration ache. Another question, should we greet anybody with Merry Christmas or reply to anyone? Generally, traditionally, scholars say, because if you greet, Muslims are generous, but if you greet with this kind of word, it means that you are supporting the belief behind this celebration, which is shirk. Although some scholars say, yes, somebody if greet to you, you can reply with other greet, but not with this wording. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِذَا حُيِّيْتُمْ بِتَحَيَّةٍ فَأَحْيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا. If somebody greet you, so you reply with the greatest greeting, nice greeting, But the word related with shirk, Muslims should not utter it. Is it allowed that we order turkey and in Thanksgiving Day we also eat and we cook turkey, a special food? Yes, turkey is halal food if it is slaughtered by the name of Allah, but not on the day. If you do it, you are copying their culture, which has some belief related with that. Turkey apni khete paren bochhore jei kono din, tobe shei din Thanksgiving Day jokhon tara eta khacche shetar sathe ekta bishwasher somporko ache, oi somporko theke bachte hobe. So finally, I would like to request all Muslim brothers who attended today's Jummah, please, it is our duty to pass the aqidah, proper creed, to our next generation. If you don't do it, and they are also believing the same stories of Santa, Christmas Father and other things, so you will be responsible for that. তাদের কাছে সত্য ঘটনাগুলো তুলে ধরতে হবে এবং তাদের কাছে কোরআনের এই বাণীগুলো প্রকাশ করে যেতে হবে, নতুবা আমরা দায়ী থেকে যাব। আল্লাহ তাআলা আমাদেরকে এই দেশে পাঠিয়েছেন এই জন্য নয় যে ক্রিসমাসের সূত্রে নিজেদেরকে হারিয়ে দেওয়ার জন্য, আমাদের আগামী প্রজন্মকে হারিয়ে দেওয়ার জন্য আল্লাহ আমাদেরকে প্রেরণ করেননি, বরং তার বিপরীতে সত্য বিশ্বাস শুধু আমাদের পরিবারগুলো নয় বরং সাধারণ মানবতার কাছে তুলে ধরার জন্য প্রেরণ করেছেন। সেই দায়িত্ব যদি আমরা পালন না করি আমরা দায়ী থেকে যাব। আল্লাহ যেন আমাদেরকে সঠিক দায়িত্ব পালনের তাফিক দান করেন। আল্লাহুম্মা আমিন। সাল্লাল্লাহু আলাইহি ওয়া সাল্লাম।